In this video, we will see how to recover your data and fix your storage devices like SD card, USB drive, internal and external hard disk. So stay tuned. Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel HowISolve.com. HowISolve.com, a YouTube community helping people to solve everyday tech problems. Hi guys, Neil here. In today's digital world, where everyone keeps their treasured data like photos, documents, music, videos, etc. on storage medium like SD card, USB drives, internal external hard disk, losing your data can be very painful. This can happen because of many reasons, like someone or you accidentally deleted it, your file system got corrupted, your storage medium failed because of some physical damage. Because there are so many reasons for your file getting lost, we cannot guarantee you that using this guide, you would be able to recover 100% of your data. But surely, you will be able to recover some part of it, unless your storage medium has completely failed. So with that disclaimer, let's start this tutorial. This how-to guide is divided in two parts. In the first part, we will recover your data, and in the second, we will repair your storage medium. But before we begin, let's look at its prerequisites. Number one, you would require TestDisk and PhotoRec utility. These two open source based software are excellent for data recovery purpose. In fact, it is used by forensic data retrieval experts. The link for this tool is in the video description down. Secondly, you would be requiring a Windows 7, 8.1 or Windows 10 system. Third, you should be having administrative rights on the system. Fourth, storage medium has to be connected to the system. If it's a SD card, then you would require a card reader. If it's an internal hard disk from an unbootable system, you would require a SATA to a USB adapter. Both these cards doesn't cost much, around $5 to $10 each can fetch you both of them. And the most important ingredient for this tutorial to work is patience. That's right guys, patience is a must. This tutorial might take a bit of time, but I will be there to help you step by step. So be with me and everything will be right. With that, let's start this tutorial. The first step would be to connect the storage medium to your system. If you have got a USB powered device, then that's quite simple, just plug and play. Step 2 is to extract the package that you have downloaded from the link given in the video description for the two utilities, that is PhotoRec and TestDisk. I've already extracted the TestDisk and PhotoRec utility. You will get this folder on extraction, that is testdisk.win. Let's open this folder, scroll down. Here you will find this exe file, qphotorec_win.exe. Open this exe file. A warning will pop up, click yes. So this is the utility that we'll be first using to recover your data. The first thing that this utility asks is your disk from which you have to recover the data. On clicking on this drop down menu, it will list all the disks that it can detect. In my system, it's showing 3 disks. The disk from which I'll be recovering the data would be this disk, that is physical drive 2. It's a 2GB SD card. You can also identify your drive using the capacity. We'll select this, and under here it will mention the partitions that this particular disk has. This SD card just has one partition. What this utility will do is it will scan through the entire disk and search for any file type that it can find. It just goes through the raw data and search for a signature of a particular file type. If it finds that signature, then it extracts the data for that particular file. The positive thing about this extraction method is even if your file system is completely corrupt, you can still recover your files. Here it will list down all the partitions and the entire disk. So the first entry is the disk entry, and then second entry shows the partitions in that disk. We would be scanning the entire disk, so we'll select this whole disk entry, and then file system will automatically detect. Since mine is a FAT16, it will check the FAT16, FAT NTFS radio button. The next thing that it requires is the destination for a recovered file. It is very essential that you give a destination that is not on the same disk. Otherwise, it will overwrite your deleted files and you would not be able to recover any files from the disk. So here, identify a location that is on a different disk. Here, this is my backup folder that I created for this tutorial. I'll select it, select folder. There you go. Next step is to select the file formats. Click on the file formats button. By default, all the file formats are selected. I'll checkmark the file types that I want to recover. I want to recover some JPEGs, some GIF. That's it. Click OK. At this point of time, I would like to warn you that depending on the size of the disk and the amount of data that is on the disk, it might take a lot of time. So make sure that you, when you run this tool, you have that much time for it to complete. With that, let's start the scan. For that, click on search. It will take a lot of time. So I'll pause the video and then we'll continue when it finishes. Okay friends, as you can see, my recovery has completed and it has detected 8 JPG files here. This is the folder that it created, recovdir1, and these are the files that it recovered. Notice that it wasn't able to get the original file name. This is because it is not relying on the file system. The next tool that I'll be showing is TestDisk. So for that, we'll come back to the folder, scroll down, and this utility, testdisk_win.exe. We'll click, we'll open it. It will show us a warning. Click on yes, load. Okay, so it will ask us whether we want to create a log file. Hit enter. Okay, so this is a semi GUI command line kind of interface. So in this screen, it's asking us to select the disk on which we want to recover the files. As you can see again, it has detected 3 disks and we would be running this recovery tool on the third disk, that is Dave SDC, our 2GB drive. To select, we'll go down and select this using the down arrow key. And since it's already selected on proceed, we'll just hit enter. Okay. The next thing it will ask us is the partition table type. In the hint, it will show the detected partition type. Most of the time it is the same. So you can just hit enter to continue. Okay, here press the down arrow key and select advanced and hit enter. Okay, so here it's showing us the partitions in our selected drive. As you can see, there is only one partition, that is a FAT16 partition. And a couple of options that you can select with. Use the left and right arrow key to change the selection. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to recover some deleted files. We want to undelete. We'll select undelete and hit enter. Now what it does is it opens up the drive and shows any files which has been deleted in red color. So as you can see in this screen, there are no entries shown in red. So there are no deleted files here. But if I go inside a directory, also note the coding, the D's indicate a directory and the others are file permissions, which you don't require to care for this tutorial. So to identify a directory, just look whether it's a D or a dash. So as you can see in this, the test data is a directory. So select that and use the right arrow key to go inside this directory. Okay. So here you can see that there are a couple of red entries which indicate deleted files. These are the same files which the PhotoRec utility was able to recover. To select the files, press the down arrow key and stop when you reach the deleted files. And then press colon. It would be next to the L letter on a standard QWERTY keyboard. So for selecting the colon, you have to press shift and then colon. There you go. The selected file turns green in color. The next file also I have to select, so I'll do the same. Shift, colon, shift, colon, shift, colon. Okay. Now since we have selected all the deleted files that I want to recover, The next thing I want to do is copy it into a separate backup folder. To do that, you have to type capital C. So for typing capital C, press shift and then the C. Okay, now it asks us the directory where we want to copy the deleted files. It's in the directory where this utility is, that is this test disk utility. I want to go back. So for to go back, you have to select these two dots. So we'll select that two dots by pressing the down arrow key and then we'll hit enter. Okay, we went one directory back. Now I want to go one more directory back. So I'll again select those two dots. Okay, here is the backup folder. Select it and then press capital C. For that, shift plus C. Okay, so as you can see, it's written that the deleted files were copied into that folder. So I'll check that folder. As you can see, it maintained the directory structure as well as the file names. And this was a lot quicker than the previous utility. So what I recommend is, if the file system is not corrupt and you just want to recover deleted files, so you use this utility instead of the utility that I'd shown previously. Okay, now in the next part of this tutorial, I will show you how to repair corrupted file system. We'll use the same test disk utility that we used for undeleting the file. So first of all, how do you identify if a file system has got corrupted? There are basically certain symptoms that happen when a file system get corrupted, like when you insert the storage medium, it doesn't get detected, there's no drive shown, or it detects the drive but it shows no files in it, or it shows an error message something like this: you need to format the disk in drive E before you can use it. Do you want to format it? All these scenarios indicate a file system corruption. So to solve that, we will use this utility. So to go back to the screen from where we started, use the Q button. So we'll press Q, again Q, again Q, and there. If you want to change the storage medium, you can again press Q and then you return to the selection screen for the disk. Since mine is the same disk, I'll again select the same disk. It will again ask you for the partition table type. It is already selected Intel. To repair and recover a lost partition or a corrupted partition, select analyze, hit enter. You might get some warnings, but that is fine. After reaching this screen, make sure that you are selected at quick search and then hit enter. Okay, so quick search has detected this partition. To know whether this is the partition that you want to recover, we will check what all files are present in this partition. So for doing that, make sure you select the partitions that are shown on the screen and then type capital P. For that, press shift plus P. These are the files that are in this recovered partition. If you think this is the files that were there on this disk, then you can select this partition. To go back, press Q. There can also be a possibility that you are shown two partitions, one of which is actual correct partition and other one is a previous deleted partition. So to rule out which one to select, make sure you go in each of the partitions and then check the files. There can be a possibility that the quick search failed and it wasn't able to recover any new partition. In that scenario, you can run a deeper search. Select deeper search and hit enter. This will take a bit of time, so I'll pause the video and come back when the results are shown. Okay friends, as you can see, it didn't find any more partitions, so I'll just hit enter. And then to recover this partition, select write by pressing the write key and hit enter. After that, the particular partition would be written on this drive. So to quit it, just hit enter and then press Q, Q. After writing new partition, this particular disk should work properly and you should be able to see your entire data that was existing on this drive previously. But still, since this drive got corrupted, I would suggest you to backup the data on your computer and then again format it using the Windows utility. This is my file. I'll back it up. I'll back up the data. Click OK. Copy I'll paste the data over here. Yes. Okay. And then I'll just format it. Right click the drive, select on format. Ensure that the file system is selected on the default option. Mine is showing FAT. It might be different on your disk, but it should be default. Allocation unit also selected on default allocation size. You can place any label. Ensure that quick format is selected, otherwise it would take a lot of time. Click on start. It will show you warning message. Click on OK. And then again OK. So now after doing this, I would also recommend you to run a scan disk. To run scan disk will require command prompt in admin mode. In Windows 7, to open command prompt in admin mode, click on the start button, type cmd, right click and select run as administrator. A UAC will pop up, click on yes. On Windows 8.1 and Windows 10, the command prompt admin can be opened easily by right clicking on the start button and then selecting command prompt admin. Okay, so here to run chkdsk, type the command chkdsk followed by the flag slash x slash r and then followed by a drive on which you want to run the chkdsk. So we'll select J and then colon. What this command will do is it will dismount the drive and then check for bad sectors, file system errors on the device, and it will try to repair if there is any corruption. Okay, we'll hit enter. If you are trying to repair a SD card, we have a dedicated video showing how to detect a fake SD card and also find its read-write speed, in addition to how to format it in Android. To see this video, click the button that you can see on the left side of the screen. Hit the like button if your problem was solved. If this video helped you, please be part of this community. Join us in the goal of helping people with their everyday tech problems. Share this video to forums where you have visited in search of solving this problem. Join our community by supporting our channel. We love to hear your feedback and experiences. Share it in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Bye.